Here are Val Warner and Ryan Cheverini on season 10 of Windy City Live. Today on Windy City Live, it's nothing to poo-poo about. Our favorite doc duo are here for some fact and fiction.
If you were trapped without water, could you really drink your own urine? Our twin OBGYNs tell us if that's fact or fiction. We're talking bodily functions today. They are our favorite twin OBGYNs from right here in Chicago. Welcome back to Play a Little Fact or Fiction, Dr. J and Dr. I.
Hello. I missed the applause.
Where's the applause?
Oh, here, I'll give it to you, Doctor. He looks like you got a friend right behind you, Doc.
I know. Oh, yeah, he's not doing well. Quarantine's getting to him.
Really needs a meal.
Yeah. I know. I just had my studio audience of one, Maxwell Warner, applaud for you guys. I don't know if you heard it.
Today's
topic is going to be all about bodily functions. I'm so excited that we are talking about this because, you know, it's so taboo not to talk about it, but we all do it. So let's get right to it. Number one, even though the odor is bad, only 1% of one's fart is actually smelly.
Do we really have to do this segment right now?
That's the fact. Let me read it one more time.
Don't read it again.
Only 1% of one's fart is actually smelly. Fact.
All right, move on. You are correct, Val. That is a fact. You are correct. So I'm going to say my fart, or if you want to talk medicine, Plagueis, doesn't smell. But for those people where it does, so this is the thing. Gas is made up of a bunch of different things, a lot of different air. There's hydrogen, nitrous oxide, carbon dioxide, and then there's something called hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide only makes up 1% of your gas, but that is what causes the smell. So while it really can smell bad, only 1% of your gas is actually caused by something that's actually making it smell badly. If you do have bad gas like Dr. J, they say eat a lot of probiotics, prebiotics, smaller meals, a lot of water, eat faster. But it's a fact, Val. You are correct.
Okay.
Dr. J.
Yes, sir.
You just got thrown under the bus there, buddy.
Just threw me under the bus, rolled me over. That's what it is. Hey, I've been living with it my entire life. I can deal with it.
He can handle it. I'm going to win all this one. Let's get right to it, Ryan.
No, Val loves this segment. I was dreading this. All right, here we go. Men's farts smell worse than women's farts. I know someone named Val Warner, so I'm going to say that is fiction.
I agree that that's fiction.
That is fiction. Women's farts smell much worse than men's farts. And what it comes down to is basically the hormones, okay? So the hormones that women make with their cycles make their GI tracts very sluggish. So things move through more slowly. Men, it takes about 33 hours for them to digest things, get it in, get it out. Women, 47 hours. So what do you think happens over that extra 14 hours? More fermentation.
Yeah.
Fermentation means more gas. Women tend to fart 3 times more often than men do, and the gas tends to smell worse. So it is true. Women are nothing but a hotbed of hot air, and it is very unpleasant. Dank. What are we doing?
Yeah, you know, I'm actually, this is the best part about home shows, Val, for me.
This is not on here, but just a quick follow-up question. Isn't it better to actually let your gas go than to try to hold it in?
Let it go. If you let it hold in, it builds up, it ferments more, and it's even worse when you let it go. So just get it over with. Sorry.
Depends where you are.
I was going to say, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. Oh, excuse me. It doesn't matter.
No, you just gotta let it go. You just let it go and run.
Why do people do that in the elevator? I'm like, really? Somebody couldn't wait like 4 more floors?
They do it, get off, let you get on, and look like the guilty one too.
The worst. The worst when you're in a public restroom and you come out of the public restroom and you didn't make the smell. Someone else is coming in right after. Now they're gonna think it was you.
It looks like Ryan Cheverini.
All right, we gotta get to number 3. After having sex, a powerful sneeze can prevent pregnancy. I thought this was going to say after having sex, a powerful fart can prevent pregnancy. However, I am going to weigh in with, it has to be really powerful, but I'm going to go with that.
It sounds so strange that I don't think it would be on here if it wasn't a fact.
All right, guys, that is fiction. That is fiction.
Oh.
I got to keep it PC for daytime TV, but the thought is that when you sneeze, you would expel the offenders that could cause pregnancy. Let's put it that way. But you have to look at it this way. So while a sperm is only about 50 micrometers in size, it swims about 5 millimeters a minute. So that would be the equivalent of somebody that's 6 feet tall running about a 9-minute mile. It's actually moving pretty fast. And so there's no sneeze powerful enough to get them out. So there's no sneeze, there's no jumping jacks, none of that stuff is going to work. If you want to prevent pregnancy, condoms, birth control, that is the only way. Because if the sneeze worked, we'd have like sneezing powder and pillow feathers under our pillow and like, hey, you know. Yeah, no, it doesn't work. Sorry, guys.
Question though, you said that they're really fast. Not all of them are really fast though. So you can't possibly sneeze out the girl swimmers, right? The boy swimmers are faster than the girls.
You might be onto something. No. That may be a powerful fart. Before, not after.
Not
before,
even the girls.
You're not going to fart, I'm sure.
Oh, Lord. All right, next one. Here we go. Since urine is sterile, it's perfect for wounds. That's interesting. I don't know if it's perfect for wounds, but it's probably not harmful to wounds. So
fiction.
I don't know if it's perfect. I'm gonna to be opposite, I'm gonna say fact.
So it is fiction, and it makes me think of a famous Chicago R&B singer who was a healer ahead of his time, or he thought he was, but no, it's fiction. Urine is not good for any type of wounds whatsoever. Oh, I should say it's not sterile, but it's actually good for wounds, so this is the deal. As humans, we have bacteria everywhere, on the body, in the body, in our urine. But urine can actually still be good for healing wounds because basically, even though the bacteria is in the urine, there's also something called ribonucleate 7 and there's something called urea. And these are things that actually kill bacteria. And so like they actually recommend if you're somewhere where you can't irrigate with soap and water, which I would prefer, then you actually use urine. And in the Army Field Manual, they actually say if you've got a group of soldiers, use the urine from the soldier that is the darkest. So the most dehydrated soldier is the one who should basically, I guess, give you the golden shower on your wound because that's the urine that's going to be the most concentrated with the urea and the ribonucleate 7, and it's going to actually kill bacteria. So false, it's not sterile, but true, it's good for wounds.
No one's coming to our clinic anymore now.
I know.
I just couldn't imagine that scene. It's like, okay, soldiers, everybody line up. Start the stream.
Say, you're
that one.
That one there, pee on me.
Okay, let's get to number 5. If you're lost in a desert and there's no water around, it is true, you should drink your own urine.
Now that I know is a fact because we've seen stories like this time and time again with people lost in the woods for days on end and they've done this.
So that is actually fiction. I can't remember that movie where the guy was stuck in the, but anyway, you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, he got his arm cut off.
He got his arm cut, yeah. He was drinking his urine. So this is the problem. So urine is 95% water, but it's got a lot of salt content. So just like when you're lost at sea and they say don't drink the seawater because it makes you dehydrated faster, the urine will make you dehydrated faster. And when you drink it and then pee again and drink it and pee again, it becomes more and more concentrated. So do not drink your urine. And while you're at it, don't go for that cactus water because people say like cactus water is good for you. That also is very concentrated. It'll also give you massive diarrhea and vomiting. So no urine, no cactus water. Just find a shade and chill out.
And don't get stuck in the desert.
Doctor, so good to see you both. Thanks so much. We're out of time. For more on Dr. J and Dr. I, make sure you check them out on their medical blog, Twin Doctors TV. And if you have a question for the doctor, send us an email to WCL@WindyCityLive.com.